I am Mo Tuzano, the tabletop bellhop, your cardboard concierge, working with you to make your game nights better. Today, what I'm hoping to help you find out is if you would be interested in picking up a game from Lucky Duck Games called Destinies. That's what I have here in front of me. This is a game that we picked up at an awesome local game store out in Chatham, Ontario. Been looking forward to hearing, checking this game out. I've heard really good things about this. So this is considered by many people the best story-playing RPG-like experience in board game format, where you each take on a role of a character in a fantasy world trying to fulfill your destiny. Now, every character has two destinies. You're going to pick between them and then go and try to do things in the game to do it. Like other Lucky Duck games, like the Chronicle of Crime series, which is from them, this is a very app-driven game where you're going to be scanning QR codes and reading things out and listening to stories. That's about all I know about this game. So you're going to get to see my reaction to what's in this box. Right along with me, all I know is what other reviewers have said on other podcasts. I haven't deep dived this game. I haven't looked at what the components are or anything like that really yet either. So join me as I open up my copy of Destinies from Lucky Duck Games. All right, first off, a quick look at the box. I got to say, rather engaging artwork with creepy thing in the background with the giant staff and some very medieval looking characters on the cover. We're going to quickly show off the edges here. It's an interesting place to put the playtime in the player count. So as you can see here, sorry, everything's upside down. This is a longer game, right? You're looking over 2 hours per game, age 14 plus, 1 to 3 players. So that's unique. Not many games are max 3 player. Now, Board Game Geek does have this listed as best at 2, and my personal plans are to play it with my wife. All right, so right on top, we have a rule book that, of course, is the same size as the box, which is sometimes a bad thing because they flop around. But, ooh, okay, I do dig the layout here. Look at the amount of white space. Look how spaced out everything is. This is a great component overview. Nice big text. All right, here's how to get the app over here. Note the app is free. Not a lot of art. Lots of great looking examples here. This is not very thick. I'm assuming a lot of the game you probably learned through playing, through using the app and not from reading the rules. What are we up to here? 11. The item cards really remind me of the Chronicle of Crime series. That's it. So 12 pages for, you know, a 2 hour or more RPG style experience. All right, what do we have here? Oh, that's a thing on the cover. See that and that? Those match up pretty good. So we got a nice protective. I don't know what these symbols are for, just to show off. I don't know, two different symbols on there. Minis are tiny. Look how small they are. Little tiny minis. I don't think I've ever seen that in a game before. I'm saying tiny minis. Look at that. It's got multiple scorpion tails coming out. Okay, that's more of a maxi. Check that out. Okay. I'm trying to decide, do I show off each and every one of these? Or do I just kind of pan over them? You know what? Let's leave the minis for now. We'll do those last. Let's look at what we got up here. Okay, excellent. Two layer flare boards. Oh, even this is indented. That's great. I don't know what the different things are here. So obviously it looks like a card goes here. Some kind of trackers go down here. I think these are your three like stats, like whatever, wisdom, dexterity, strength, something. Only three. This is notches. I remember that for where you put your cards. Punch boards. More plastic. Okay. Really impressed by this insert here. I don't know what's supposed to go in those corners. All right. Thick cardboard punch board. Looks like gold. Some symbols that seem to match like pairs of symbols. More tokens. Some crown tokens. Okay. Not a lot though. Two punch boards. They said another whole tray thing here. Discs. Cards, more cards and cards and cards. Okay, let's start with what here. Okay, wooden discs, little tiny wooden discs, which look like. So yeah, little tiny wooden discs, which look like that you're going to fit in these. Yep, exactly. Okay, then moving on. This one's going to take forever if I do every little bit. So wooden discs, map tiles. Look at them all. Holy cow. I have no idea how much gameplay you get in this. Think it's 6 scenarios. It might be 5. But like maps, it's got to be huge. Looking for the quick release. All right, I don't want to spoil anything here, so I'm just going to like just kind of quickly grab a few. Look at the artwork on that. That's actually really nice. Some kind of bridge. Looks like there's different terrain types. Okay, let's flip them over. Oh, these are the unexplored sides, which is probably what I should have shared because they're kind of in shadow. Again, I'm going through these quick enough. I do like that the Fog of War does give you some idea of what's here. That's kind of cool. So yeah, these are your map tiles. You're going to explore while playing. Put those here. These look like characters. I don't know if the whole deck is characters. So again, we got shrink wrap to take care of. So yeah, different characters. And the whole thing in this game is destiny. You're trying to fill your destiny. That's a lot of different characters. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, let's say 15 different characters. I don't want to spoil their destinies, but they're on this side. You get a little intro, and these are the two possible destinies. So when playing whatever character this is, I don't even want to look. You're going to pick between these two and work towards them. That's how much I know about this game. And then when you're doing that, these are your two destinies. So you're like, oh, I'm going to talk to the person about my white destiny. I'm going to scan this, and so on. So artwork's really nice. Again, reminds me of other games from Lucky Duck. Looks great. Put that there. Here it looks like we have items. Yeah, so we have a horse with a special ability it does and a way to scan it to use the horse. And I'm not going to go through all of these, but we have a shield. Again, really digging the artwork, a bow. We have a talisman. Getting a little washed out here, sorry. Food. Rosaries. Holy water. Herbs. Whole stack full. There's probably more. Based on what I'm seeing here, looks like there are way more. Okay, there might be a massive stack of items in this game. All right, more herbs, medicine, alcohol, swords, torches, rope. Look at them all. Doctor's mask. That is a big stack, and we have more of them. Are these numbered? Yes, this is number 23. That's number 11. This is also number 11. Going down to number 1. So if I stack these on top, we should be all good. Look, there's more. More items. Wow. When I hold this up, you'll see just how many items are in this somewhat ridiculous stack. All right, we got another one. Yeah, more. Oh, these look a little different. Okay, these look like the rest of the items. These, I don't know what the difference is, but they're like a different border. Reddish border, but same back. So I don't know. Advanced items, magic items. I don't think they're magic. I see like toolbox and lyre. Artwork again. Very cool. Tarot card deck. Ability list on the bottom. A crow. Yeah, I'm not sure why these are a different color. Again, if I flip this, it should be highest number on the top. So yes. Look at that. That's your item deck in Destinies. That's an impressive stack. Will all this fit into one spot? No. I wonder if I pull out the red ones and put them separate, if it will. Yeah, it looks like it. I don't know what the red ones are. I'm going to put the red ones in a different stack than the rest here. Just for my own sake. Sorry, I'm a little off camera here. Next, we have the dice. Oh, they're different sizes. Interesting. All right, I'm just going to take one of these out. All right, we have a 1, a 3, a 1, and a 3, a 4, and a 2. So not a standard D6. Two 1s, two 3s, a 2, and a 4. Odd distribution. I like the size of these. They're etched too, which is always nice. So you don't have to worry about like paint rubbing off over the years. So I don't know anyone who plays their games enough for the paint to rub off like they did, say, on my copy of Hero Quest nowadays. It's still good to see. And then other dice. Looks like you get two of these dice and three of the other per player. All right, we have special symbol. I like the purple. 2, 3, 2, 1, 1. So 1, 1, 2, 2, 3 special symbol on these purple smaller dice. 1. Put these back in the bag. And that's it. All we have left are miniatures. Oh, nice. The tray even shows you what to put. Well, where? Look, spot for dice. I don't know what these spots are for. Does this show anything? I don't know. Some kind of tokens. These obviously go on top here. The characters we're going to put here. All right. All these minis. What is going? Oh, I didn't fit all the dice. My bad. In the baggies, that's a tight fit. This spot's confusing me a bit. But other than that, very nice insert. I love the fact that's now indented to hold all these. Like, that's just cool. I gotta figure out which way these are facing. The punch boards were underneath. Oh, these are gonna be for the tokens. That makes sense. The four troughs. Gotta be for the four tokens. Yeah, and these nest right there. Nice. All right. Minis. All right, so we have a tiny little skeleton. Are there multiple? No, they're all unique. I'm going to lose these, and if I don't put them back in the same spot, I'll never find them again, or are they all generic? Wow. Okay, I'm going to need pictures of these. Look at how small these minis are. So we're just going to take bunch of these out. I'm going to lay them flat so you kind of see them. This zoomed in. Even my camera doesn't want to do it. All right. This does not seem worth doing because I can't get them into focus very well. But yeah, you can kind of tell it's like I don't have something to compare this to give you a size comparison, really. But undead, dude with scythe. At this point, I'm just going to put them back. I'll show off some of these here. It's like a guy holding. Here, this is probably about as good as it's going to get. I knew the game had minis, but I did not realize they were minis. So you can kind of see. So these are put out onto that map tiles. I know that much from seeing some previous reviews. This makes me somewhat glad I am not really a miniature painter anymore. Because the tiny minis. I don't even know what scale these are. So I think over here, we're using these are all unique. I think these are the heroes. That's a cool looking one. So I'm just going to move this over and kind of show you this way. What you get. So unfortunately, I'm running out of room. Yeah, this is showing off. Check out the angel. So we're just going to pan across. Love this bishop looking guy. You already saw the big dude. Just kind of panning around these is probably the best way to do it. Even then, it's having a hard time focusing. Ton of little minis here. Show off a couple of them. Here's like someone holding a chalice up on a set of rocks. Fortunately, it's really hard to get these to focus with their size. That is one of the coolest form of rats I've ever seen for minis. Various characters. Super tiny. Little tiny mini. Except for this. I assume this is your final fight, final destiny, end of the campaign. Alright, and you get this nice tray to hold everything. So it's really weird. I wonder what was originally under these. It's weird that they're different. Like all the rest of this fits. It's odd to have these two symbols. Alrighty. What you get with Destinies from Lucky Duck Games. I am hyped. This looks really cool. Shocking amount of stuff in this box, though kind of confusing because there's not a lot of different components. You only have two sets of punch boards. You've got a large amount of miniatures, little tiny miniatures like this big, that was except for like the big monsters. little tiny miniatures for the heroes and various points of interest. A deck of item cards that was like this thick, some character cards and location cards, and that's about it. But that's what you get when you have an app-driven game. You don't need all that other stuff. Now, the two punch boards of components, you do have some nice little trackers. So this says, first competitive, story-driven, RPG-like board game ever. So they're really proud of the fact. Part of what sold this game to my family is my wife was very interested once she learned it was competitive. It's like, ooh, competitive, not cooperative campaign game. I want to play it. What I don't know at this time is how replayable it is. If it's scenarios or a full campaign, my understanding, I think it's a full campaign where you level up in between, or if you need to play the whole thing with the same group. Now, I have heard it's best at two, so my plan is to play through this with my wife. But if I can replay some, I want to get my partner involved and have Sean also play with us so we can try a three-player. Now, I may or may not end up doing a formal review on this. This is not a pile of obligation. We bought this ourselves because I've heard really good things about it. But if I do review this, it'll be over at tabletopbellhop.com, as well as on YouTube and on our podcast, the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast. If you want to talk about this game, if you know Destiny, I don't want spoilers, but if you want to tell us about it, it'd be really cool if you went over to the Tabletop Bellhop Discord and started a conversation. You can find that at discord.tabletopbellhop.com. Thank you for joining me for this unboxing video. Good day and game on.